Neighborhood Association's annual Christmas tree lighting. It's nice to see as many people here as we have, and I thank you for taking the time to come out. I had to make a few notes, but I did it in my phone, so I'm trying to save a tree. But 3 years ago, we started to do the tree lighting in memory of baby Owen Simmons, and which was such a beautiful, cute baby. And every time I tried to do a fundraiser through the Safe Zones organization that I run, Owen was having a fundraiser done for him, so I figured we could do a tree lighting that nobody else was doing for him. So this is how we started it. And after speaking with the Simmons family last year, I felt that we should open the tree up to our kids in our community that we lose too early. And the Simmons family was right there, and they were excited to, you know, open a tree up to everybody. So I want to just thank the Simmons family. And, you know, we feel everybody's pain that they're going through, but we're all a family of one, and we're all together. And if you look around, the kids that we've lost brought us all together tonight, which I think is a great, great thing. And I'm very happy and proud to see everybody here and see the good things that are going on in the city of New Bedford. Now tonight, again, our tree's gonna be lit in memory of Owen Simmons, Alex Vieira from Greater New Bedford Vote, Andrew McCann from Greater New Bedford Vote, Elijah Lopes from Keith Middle School. We lost him to suicide, unfortunately. Clifford Rodriguez from Roosevelt. We lost him also from a suicide. The young lady that we lost last week at the Gomes School, she was a teenager. She was a kid from our community. And I just feel it's important that we recognize her also. And then unfortunately, when I was watching the news this week, it brought tears to my eyes that we lost two more kids in Taunton due to a car accident and a young boy from Plymouth. And it really, really breaks my heart to lose anybody, especially our kids. And I didn't expect when we started to do the tree thing that it would be so, you know, tough on me as an organizer, because I just thought it was just a nice thing that we were doing. But emotionally, it's really tough. And I tell our parents, value your kids. They drive us nuts. But value them, because unfortunately, when we lose them, we lose them. And, you know, give them that extra hug. Let them know I love you. Read them the book. But just value our kids. And more importantly, we need to value each other and always be together and pull together and be there to support one another. My friends here from Greater New Bedford Vote, students, awesome turnout, staff members, parents. It's just, this is overwhelming to me to see as many people here, and you guys deserve a round of applause. Thank you. So at 6:30, we're gonna have a visit for the little kids from Mrs. and Mr. Claus. And he loves pink. And I believe he's gonna be giving anyone with a pink jacket the candy cane and hot cocoa. And no, sorry, counselor, you didn't wear your pink. And we're going to have hot cocoas and cookies, and which was compliments of Henry Bousquet from Greater New Bedford Vote. So we really need to thank Henry. Thank you, Henry, very much. Now, Councilor Jane Gonzalez could not make it. 35 years ago, URI had a huge fire, and unfortunately, they lost a group of students, and they were her friends. But we had a situation with that Christmas tree this year, and Councilor Gonzalez said, whatever you guys need, I will replace the tree for you. But everything came in for us. But she wanted to thank everybody for showing up, and extends an invitation to all the families where we read off the names. Anything you need, she's there for you. And last, on my end, we're having a toy drive tomorrow, and everyone that did bring a toy and put it under the table, thank you so much. But the toy drive is going to be at the Boat Restaurant just south of Greater New Bedford Regional Vote Technical High School. And from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m., we'll be accepting toys. It's called Fill the Bus at the Boat. and all the tourists will benefit our local organizations in the city of New Bedford. So you're more than willing to walk by and do a donation. And I believe that's all that I have to say, but I'm going to hand the mic over to Alves. He's, Medeiros, I don't know why you got that, but he represents State Rep Tony Cabral, and then we'll hear from Councilor David. I don't have my pink jacket on, Alves.
Thank you very much. Thank all of you for coming out today. I'm truly impressed by this crowd. It's an excellent, excellent crowd. I wanted to extend a special thank you to Jerry Pinto. Jerry Pinto is basically he's been a one-man show. And on behalf of... On behalf of Representative Cabral, myself, and the rest of our staff, we wish you a very happy Merry Christmas and a safe New Year as well. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Do you need me to lower the mic for you?
Go ahead, Dave.
I want to get even with the mayor. I'll lower the microphone and then let him work at it.
Hey, I just want to say welcome to all of you and thank you for showing up and making New Bedford the kind of place that we all love to live in. You know, we talked about memorial ceremony today, and we've done this every year. But as much as I want to respect the families that we've talked about and have lost children, I think tonight's event about the kids that are here. And that's what we want to remember, that, you know, Christmas is all about the kids. It's not about those of us that are older, like Jerry and the mayor. It's about the kids that are here, and that's what makes Christmas. And in New Bedford, we've been doing tree lighting throughout the city at each one of the community or neighborhood associations. You know, each city councilor tries to get to as many, and just before this event, there was one down at the South End Library that other city councilors attended. There was something at the Whaler Museum that the mayor is coming in from. I drew the straw for this one because it's always a great event. It's a great neighborhood. You've got a lot of participation, and I'm so proud of the number of people that are here. And I want to say thank you for the parents for bringing the kids out. I'm hoping that the kids will be as impressed with Santa Claus as I always am. And that's because I'm not much taller than you, so Santa still gives me a cookie, okay? But on behalf of the city council, on behalf of the city of Bedford, thank you for showing up tonight. Thank you for participating. And on behalf of all of us, Merry Christmas. Have a great New Year. Thank you. And now it's my honor as a city councilor, and I had the opportunity to work with the mayor for a number of years, well, for this year, for a number of events, I should say. It's always a pleasure to have him join us. It's always a pleasure to hear from the mayor, bring the words of the city official and city government to all of you. On behalf of the city, let me introduce Mayor John Mitchell. John?
Hey, Dave, you forgot to raise the microphone for me. Come on now.
Yeah.
All right, can everybody hear me?
No, do I have to
bend down? All right, hey, thank you.
These guys with physical impairments.
All right. Well, listen, this is great. You know, I've done a lot of tree lighting ceremonies over the last week, and they are lots of fun because they are occasions to bring neighborhoods together and to make neighborhoods stronger, and this is no exception. In fact, don't tell anybody, but I think this is the biggest crowd out of all of them around the city, so you guys should be proud of yourself. Let's hear you. Which is good. How are you, buddy? Let me first of all recognize a couple of wonderful families that have lost young loved ones recently. And that's the McCanns and the Simmons, who are great families that have done so much for our city. And I know this is, you know, this time of year is a difficult time, but I want you to know that we're all thinking about you this time of year. And we really appreciate everything that you guys have been doing. Let me ask the kids something. On a brighter note, let me ask the kids something. Are you kids listening up there?
Yeah.
All right, by a show of hands, you ready? Who's been naughty? Dick Pond's been naughty, I know that. All right, who else? You've been naughty? All right, Who's been nice? Which one of you kids have been nice?
I've been somewhat nice.
All right, excellent. All right, excellent. All right, Santa's keeping track of all of you. Listen, Christmas is a time of giving. Just let's all remember that. So I want all you kids to do something nice for your parents this year. They've done a lot for you. I want you to say thank you for all the things that they do for you. Have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. 2012 has been a fantastic year for New Bedford, and 2013 is going to be even better. So don't you worry, Jerry. This is my sixth tree lighting. I got this down. I know how to do a tree lighting. All right. So I think we're ready. I want to thank Bank 5 also for sponsoring this event tonight. We really appreciate your responsible and good corporate citizenship. All right. So let me start. Where's the tree? This is the tree right here.
That bright light wasn't me.
Yeah, that's right. All right. Who's ready to count down? You guys ready? Start at 10. You can all do it. Ready? Let's go. 10.
9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1.
Hit it. Merry Christmas, everybody.
That's me. I know you.
I want to be on TV.
All right, Casey McGarris just wants to come up here real quick. And then
Mom, I
heard Santa is right down the street. So just give Casey McGarris a minute from Bank 5, and then we can go and have our cocoa.
Thank you, everyone. Especially Jerry Pinto. Can I have everyone's attention, please? First of all, I want to thank everyone from the community for coming out. You guys are awesome. Give yourselves a round of applause. You guys are the best. You guys are the best. I'm Tracy Medeiros, Assistant Branch Manager at Bank 5 in Fairhaven. And not only do I want to thank everyone here, but as my husband, Al Medeiros, recognized Joey Pinto for all of his great, extensive community service, always willing to give a hand no matter what the situation is. And we just have a donation to tonight's event for Jerry. And Jerry, keep up the fantastic work. You are a mentor to everyone, and for the benefit of our community, he is just an outstanding individual. Merry Christmas, everyone!
Merry Christmas!
Good job, Jerry.
It's over there.
All right, so listen, when Santa does come and I hear the siren, what we need to do is have the kids line up after Santa and Mrs. Claus sits down, and then they'll see the kids, and then you can just do a U-turn to get hot cocoa and brownies and cookies. And I just want to thank everybody for being here tonight, and enjoy the rest of the night.
Wait a minute,
it's gonna blink you a little bit.
I'm gonna be Roman now.
from that period. He's from Rome.
Say hello. Wave. Wave hello. Out of his light, you're in his light.
Oh, I'm in his light, I totally am in his light.
Say Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Say Merry Christmas, you bet. Kid, you can even talk in here. Say Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
What's your name?
Lou.
All right. You want to talk in the mic? Go ahead. You gotta say your name and Merry Christmas.
I can't say my name. Where is my name? I'm Luke.
Stand on this side. Come over here. Stand over here.
How are you? I'm Luke.
No. Luke. Over here. Okay, now do it.
Merry Christmas.